This right here is the TB70 from Harley Benton. It's their take on the legendary Thunderbird from Gibson. And it even comes with a set neck, which is very surprising in this price range. So let's check it out. Hi everyone, Gregor here, and today I'm once again accompanied by my friend René Flexen McBeardface. This Harley Benton bass is very different from all the other Harley Benton basses that we've tested before, and that is mainly because it sounds nothing like the original that it's based on, which is not necessarily a bad thing because I'm sure there will be a lot of people who will actually consider this an improvement. The Gibson Thunderbird is one of the coolest looking rock basses ever made, if it's not even the coolest looking rock bass ever made. It probably is, but it sounds very special. It has lots of mids, and that's because it's all mahogany. It's a neck through construction which comes with a lot of sustain, and the pickups are also a little bit special, and all this package together is not necessarily what people would look for in a rock bass sound, at least today. This Harley Benton sounds very different. It's modern, it's crispy, and it's just super clean. The TB70 also comes with a mahogany body. We have a mahogany neck, which is set in, which is similar to neck through, but it sounds completely different. And the reason for that, of course, only can be the pickups and the electronics. Speaking of electronics, this bass has two pickups, but no pickup blend and no pickup switch, which is kind of weird. So that means they're both active at all times. I mean, they're passive pickups, but they're active. I hope you know what I mean. What you can do instead is pull this out and switch these pickups either serial or parallel. So let's check this out. The other two controls are active basses and highs, and I really dig this matte black finish that Harley Benton does. Of course, it leaves a lot of fingerprints and this kind of stuff, but I just like it. Otherwise, we have a 34-inch scale neck, which is standard. We have 38 millimeters width at the nut, so these are basically standard jazz bass measures. Of course, it feels nothing like a jazz bass, but it's just that we are in this ballpark. And then we have this cool reversed headstock. And of course, with such a long neck, with this construction, always comes a cool extra feature. It's neck heavy as hell. And of course it is. That's just the price that you have to pay to look cool on stage. In Germany, we have a saying, which is wer schön sein will, muss leiden, which means who wants to be pretty must suffer. And yes, that's of course a prime example of the famous German humor, which is so well respected all around the world. But the most important question hasn't even been asked yet, so let's do this now. Does this bass actually rock? The great thing about these kind of constructions is that the neck just sits super solid in the body. It's glued in there, it's staying there, it's not going anywhere else. With bolt-on basses, you can easily bend them back and forth and use this as an effect to bend also the tone, of course. With those basses, this is getting very hard. And that's might be also one of the reasons why these basses feel very different to play. It's just so stiff, but I think there are more things to it. I think it has also to do when you're sitting down that your arm is always here, which kind of pushes the bass in a different angle. So Thunderbird players, experts, speak up. What do you think? Why do these basses feel so different? I actually like it because I feel I have more control here. So what are your thoughts? Let me know. To wrap this up, I'm an old guy, so naturally I have mixed feelings about this bass. Of course, it plays and sounds and looks very decent. It's a typical Harley Benton, so there's not really much to complain yet. It's a very decent bass for its money. But it's just not what I was expecting. I'm very aware that this is not the basis, it's my problem, but yeah, it's there. But I'm sure there will be especially a lot of younger players who will really appreciate the sound. So you've seen it, you've heard it. what do you think? Please let me know in the comments below. And if you want to try one yourself, there's a link in the comments, in the video description, that's the way, which guides you to the Thomann website where you can buy this base or other ones, or can buy anything else from Thomann. And if you do that through that link, we as Base will get a little kickback from them, which is very nice. So that's an easy way to support us, doesn't cost you any money, and allows me to buy another Lambo one day, because this one here is broken. The RC is only working for like 1 or 2 meters, very sad. This is actually for my childhood. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and bye bye.